I mean, there's no other way to state it besides this is just extremely disrespectful to the entire community. Like, all right, now finally, it is time to test out the final version for a feature that pretty much doesn't work. Probably what, you know, maybe a year in the making, this camo right here. All right, and welcome back, guys, and it is finally time. There is officially a Pack-a-Punch camo in Vanguard Zombies. This has been many, many months in the making. This game's been out for 60 plus days, and they have finally spent the time, made a Pack-a-Punch camo, and we're going to fully review everything about it. So since it took so long to make this, you would think it is pretty freaking amazing, and we're gonna find that out today. One, we are going to be starting with a Mastercraft weapon, because I wanna see exactly how this camo looks like on Blueprint Weapons. I already know the answer, but we're gonna hop into game, test it out. We're also gonna be testing out all three different camos. We're gonna be reviewing them, see how they play in Zombies, and just kinda talking in general about this camo, and yeah. So hopefully it's pretty good, because like I said, we have been waiting a very, very long time for this, so it should be pretty good. And just like that, here we are, loaded in game, doing an objective, and there is a very specific reason we picked this weapon. Mainly, one, because it's a Mastercraft weapon, it's cool. And the main reason I wanted the Pack-a-Punch camo, and I feel like most of the other people in the community want it, is the one of the best parts in Zombies is testing out the different blueprints, seeing how they look with camos. And that's like 95% of the reason the Pack-a-Punch camo was pretty important to me and the reason it wasn't here. We do a lot of like bundle reviews, a lot of stuff like that. And the first thing I do with a bundle review, you guys know, is we hop into Zombies, we Pack-a-Punch it, and see what it looks like with all the different tier of Pack-a-Punch camos. All right, go ahead, upgrade our Ring of Fire. But yeah, so essentially I've got to do a bunch of objectives. I've got to get the 7,500 points that is required to Pack-a-Punch our weapon so we can see the camo. And it's just like, you know, Cold War. And actually, it's just like Cold War. There's another game like it. Every single tier of Pack-a-Punch, you get a new camo. So tier one has a camo, tier two and tier three. And we're going to be checking out all of those while I'm currently, you know, opening up the map, getting the points. If you're new here and want to sub, I would greatly appreciate that. And on top of that, I got to give a massive thanks. Obviously, to like, comment, and watch this video in its entirety, as those three things definitely do massively help out my channel, especially now that things with Vanguard are not obviously doing anywhere near as Cold War, so I do appreciate you guys. Thank you for that. All right, upgrade a Ring of Fire. All right, boys, it is time. Are you ready for the Pack-a-Punch camo that was not ready at launch, and then we had to wait an additional 2+ months on top of that to be in the game? All right, here we go. Pack-a-Punch in the Mastercraft, and yep, here it is. This is the fantastic Pack-a-Punch camo that we've waited 2 months for, plus the development time of this game, so probably what, you know, maybe a year in the making, this camo right here. If you haven't found out, camo is completely bugged out. It does not work on any blueprints. It works just fine on normal weapons, but if you go to the Pack-a-Punch machine, Pack-a-Punch any blueprint, as of right now, the camo does not work on a single one of them. So, you know, all the blueprints you spent money for, unlocked, on challenges for, because most people, when they're using weapons, put it on blueprints. Unless it's a new DLC weapon that just came out, or it's a weapon they haven't done, you know, a challenge blueprint unlock for, most of the time, that's what people are using if they have one. And that entire factor of the Pack-a-Punch camo does not work properly, completely bugged out, which is kind of disappointing. The fact that we have now waited 2+ months for a feature that pretty much doesn't work is a little disappointing. However, we are able to actually see what the camos look like if we get a normal weapon, so now we're gonna go do that. So right off the bat, not the best start. I mean, it wouldn't have been that bad if this was launched. Like, these are issues you kind of understand. Oh, there was a shield in the box. I still haven't used, the shield looks so weird in the mystery box. Issues like this usually aren't that bad if we're, you know, at the launch date of the game, but we are 2 months into this game now, and the Pack-a-Punch camo is still completely broken after an update that was supposed to fix it. But at least let's see, I guess we'll do the O1 gun. This seems like it's probably got pretty good coverage. We're gonna see all three different camo coverage, but yes, it is true. You have to use a base variant of a gun because the blueprint section of it is completely bugged out at this point in time. All right, now it's time to get our actual first look at the Pack-a-Punch camo. We're using a weapon that it's actually going to work on this time. And yeah, I guess just we'll hop into it. This is the tier one Pack-a-Punch camo in Vanguard. And all right, so right off the bat, and I've said this a million times, and I don't know why, this just kind of got forgotten about when it comes to Vanguard. The most important thing for a Zombies camo is it has to light up. That is kind of like, and I know it didn't do it originally, right when Pack-a-Punch camos first started coming out, obviously in World at War and Black Ops 1, that didn't happen in those games. But then again, there weren't really any sort of glowing camos in the game. But more recently, pretty much every single zombie map and every zombies game has light up Pack-a-Punch camos, because the thing about zombies take place in dark settings. And when you have camos that have no light up effects, no like illumination, no glow, you can't see them in most scenarios. Yeah, if you're right here, you can see it well, but most of the spots on the map, it's gonna be somewhat like over here, especially when you're indoors, and you can barely see this. Like, zombies camos have to be illuminated in some way, shape, or form. But when you actually bring it into the light, this actually looks really cool. Like, I like this camo. This would be a fantastic multiplayer camo, but if we're being honest, this just isn't a zombies camo. If it had any sort of glow to it, it definitely would look amazing. And it does. When you can see it in the light, it looks amazing. But the biggest issue with this is zombies, and zombies isn't bright. So most of the time when you're actually using the camo, this is what you can realistically expect to see, which isn't much of anything. But I really like this camo, and maybe if we get a brighter zombies map, we'll actually be able to fully appreciate this, because it is a beautiful looking camo. It's got kind of like a crystal, almost like gem style look to it, and the starting base color, the red, is really cool. It just doesn't work in zombies, and this should not be a zombies camo. This should be introduced in some way in multiplayer, allow you to unlock it, or maybe even add some sort of like glowing light to the red. But the base tier is just kind of a garbage Pack-a-Punch camo. It's a good camo, but it is a garbage Pack-a-Punch camo, especially when the only map in zombies right now is a dark map. All right, Pack-a-Punch tier 2 time. Let's go ahead, Pack-a-Punch it a second time. And this one actually looks a lot cooler. The accent color is like this chrome. And I'm not gonna lie, this actually looks really sharp. But then again, right now we're in the light. This would look fantastic if maybe there was a little bit of glow underneath like the gemstone part. But once we start taking it into a darker area, because it is a zombies map, it quickly fades away. And this to me kind of just looks like another common camo you would get. And it is better. Tier 2 is definitely a lot better than tier 1 because it has lighter parts to it, allowing it to be seen a little bit better in the dark. And if you were to be able to use this in MP, this would actually look really cool. But we're not talking about a multiplayer camo. We're talking about a zombies camo. So we have to rank it as such. And you gotta understand, most of zombie scenarios are going to be in this dark light where it is really not that noticeable. So if we were to rank the first one, I would rank that as a Pack-a-Punch camo probably a 1 out of 10. This would probably be a 3 out of 10. But there is still one more tier, so let me save up the 30,000 points so we can get and rank the final Pack-a-Punch tier. All right, now finally, it is time to test out the final version of the Pack-a-Punch camo. And like I said, this looks good if this was a multiplayer camo. That looks fantastic. This right here in the light is sick. But once again, we're playing zombies. We're not playing multiplayer. And once you take it in the dark, you can't see anything because it doesn't have any sort of glow, any sort of anything. And that's why most recent Pack-a-Punch camos, especially if it's a dark map, if you're playing on a dark map, it has some sort of glow, some sort of light. And it doesn't even look like these camos were meant for zombies. These look like some sort of scrap that was made for a bundle for MP, and then they just kind of threw them in zombies, because these don't look like even remotely made for zombies, at least not for this map, because this is a really dark map and it just doesn't work. And I hate to be so negative about, but I mean, it's just like this whole thing is the whole Pack-a-Punch camo saga now is just extremely disrespectful to the community. Like, this is, I don't think I would have the same gripes that I currently have if we wouldn't have waited 2 months. If this was launch and it's like, okay, the Pack-a-Punch camo is pretty badly bugged, and on top of being bugged, they're reused camos from multiplayer that have just kind of been slapped into zombies too many times. If this was 2 months ago at launch, I would have been like, all right, I understand that. But this game launched without a Pack-a-Punch camo, and they have spent 2 months updating this game to give us these. To give us camos that weren't even made for zombies, that don't even work with the mode, and then 90% of the time, it's gonna bug out and not put a camo on your weapon. Like, at launch, that would have been acceptable, but this isn't launch. This is 2 months after the game has launched. This game has gone through 15% of its life cycle without a Pack-a-Punch camo, and who knows when they're actually going to update and fix this camo. Who knows how long it's going to have this broken, bug, barely working camo after waiting 2 months after launch. And it's just, honestly, it's just, I mean, there's no other way to say it besides this is just extremely disrespectful to the entire community. Like, it would have been better just to wait an extra couple of months. I mean, we've already waited 60 plus days. It should have just came when it was ready, and clearly 2 months wasn't enough time to develop the Pack-a-Punch camo, because not only does it not work in zombie, well, one, it doesn't work, it doesn't apply on most weapons, but when it does apply, this looks like a reused MP camo that was not made for the zombies mode. And when you look at it in the light, like, look at this, this looks fantastic, but you're only going to see it in this light in very, very, very few scenarios. So my suggestion for fixing this is, honestly, one, it's got to be updated so it works on all weapons, not just a few small select of them. And the camo itself needs to glow in some way. If they take the gemstone part of it and make it light up, make it glow, anything along those lines would instantly make this so much better. And I don't know, like, I really don't think there's any other way to say this other than it was just, this is kind of a giant slap in the entire community's face to make us wait 2 months for a feature that looks like it was rushed out of the door with very little development time on it. And think about that. There has never been, even World at War that came out, what, in 2008, when they released the third map pack, Darice, when that map pack came out, the introduction of the Pack-a-Punch camo, it worked in zombies. And there was a camo for all weapons that worked and always applied. And that was the moment the Pack-a-Punch machine was introduced. And ever since then, ever since 2008, every version of zombies, except for maybe some of the mobile games, but every main series zombies game has had a working Pack-a-Punch camo at launch. In this game, the $60 game with an $100 edition launched without a working Pack-a-Punch camo. And then 2 months later, after waiting 2 months for the camo, we get a barely developed unworking camo for most weapons that really wasn't even made or planned for the zombies mode. And I just don't think there's any other way to phrase that. There's really no other better thing you can say about it. It's just, this is just extremely disrespectful to the community. And that's where I'm going to leave that. Those are my opinions on it. Maybe yours might differ. Maybe you think this is a fantastic looking camo, this non light up, very bland, doesn't work in dark scenarios, doesn't work on most weapons camo. And if that's the case and you're happy with it, that is amazing. But to me, I feel extremely disrespected with this update. And that's a lot of the things we got yesterday in the update. A lot of it was just kind of disrespectful to the community. And that's where I'm going to leave this before I continue here and continue on this rant. But if they ever do update the Pack-a-Punch camo, we will do another video going through testing all the tiers, reviewing it, seeing how it looks. So let me know what you think of the Pack-a-Punch camo. Out of the three camos, which one is your favorite? My favorite is the final one. I think tier 3 definitely looks the best. And I would love to be able to use this camo in MP where I can actually show it off and actually see what it looks like. But we'll just have to take what we can get for now. And yeah, with that, guys, thank you for watching this entire video, even with the rant at the end. And as always, I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace. Oh, hey there. Thank you for watching the entire video. I've got to take this last moment here to give a huge thanks to everyone who became a Twitch sub or a YouTube member, and extra special thanks to those who have taken above and beyond and became an Unlock Plus Plus member on YouTube. We've got the 2X Trader Purple. We've got the most OP Gobblegum ever, Round Robin. We have the hero Arrow Pharaoh. And then we've got the absolute legend, Peyton Perkins. Once again, got to give a huge thanks to all of them for becoming Unlock Plus Plus members here on YouTube.